Mr. Chair, I have an amendment at the desk.
The clerk will designate the amendment.
Amendment number 4, printed in Part A of House Report number 114-420, offered by Ms. Kelly of Illinois.
Pursuant to House Resolution 609, the gentlewoman from Illinois, Ms. Kelly, and a member opposed, each will control 5 minutes. The chair recognizes the woman from Illinois.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. My amendment is simple. It merely expands the report the Treasury Secretary must submit per the underlying bill to include an analysis of economic cost of failing to raise the debt limit, especially with regard to cost to our nation's public health and safety. I agree with my friends on the other side of the aisle that misguided deficit spending poses a serious risk to our nation's long-term financial stability. It is crucial that we get our fiscal house in order. Simply raising the debt limit without discussing strategic ways to increase revenues and cut costs is unacceptable. Equally unacceptable is not acknowledging the serious short and long-term costs of failing to raise the debt limit, causing the country to enter into default. Federal tax dollars fund a variety of programs in every single one of our congressional districts that are essential to the continued well-being of our constituents. Seniors rely on Social Security checks and Medicare reimbursements. Veterans depend on their much-needed VA benefits. State and municipal police forces receive funding through Department of Justice grants. Our nation's hospitals receive federal tax dollars. It is not an exaggeration to say that if the United States of America defaulted on its loan obligations, if it could not pay its bills for expenses already incurred, the health and safety of its citizens would be put at risk. If America were to enter default, what would happen? Would the Social Security Administration be able to cut checks? How many Americans will be unable to obtain essential medications? Will Customs and Border Protection, TSA, or state and local police units furlough agents and officers? How many less cops will be on the beat to keep our communities safe? All too often, our debates in Washington about the national debt and deficit are not grounded in reality. We simply analyze economic concepts in the abstract. But our decisions, our debates have real, immediate, and lasting impact on the daily lives of our constituents. If we're going to engage in a discussion on the pros and cons of raising the debt ceiling, let's keep in mind the real, on-the-ground consequences that the decisions will have on everyday Americans. If we're going to require the Treasury Secretary to report on the cost of the growing national debt, let's be fair and require that report to discuss the immediate and lasting costs of failing to raise a debt ceiling on our nation's public health and safety. The bill's author, the gentleman from Texas, Mr. Martian, stated his goal was to have a comprehensive discussion of the debt ceiling. A comprehensive discussion must include not only the long-term costs of continued deficit spending, but the short-term costs of default, as well as its far-reaching ripple effects. This amendment is common sense, intellectually honest, and fair. It would have zero budgetary impact and will ensure the report is as meaningful as possible. I urge my colleagues on both sides of the aisle to support it. Mr. Chair, I yield back my time.